Horn Church in Essex, King Buxton.
Low and flat, the second fastest in the heat at up to 80 miles an hour. It has four-wheel drive, can flip upside down and still run effectively. It's protected by a 3mm thick aluminium shell. The movable titanium spikes look dangerous for the joust to come.
Robot ears, stand by.
First to the gauntlet, King Buxton.
We'll take the top off. We'll show you inside. We've got quite powerful motors, 750 watt motors. This is part of our lifting device. Speed controllers, which we've built ourselves. Four-wheel drive, chain drive, and quite a large reservoir of batteries.
3, 2, 1.
And they'll need all those batteries, whichever way they go in the gauntlet. Providing they know how to steer the thing, that is. Simon Harrison, Phil Brett and Steve Monk. Come on, boys, steer the thing. There's the ramp. With the barrels on top, up onto the ramp now. Ooh, and off it again. Well, a slightly circuitous route, this, against the tank trap. There's the ram rig ready to squeeze, and Matilda and the sphere rolling away. They've done enough to push the sphere away. Now can they get beyond Matilda? Smart fly! They do go beyond Matilda. In comes Kilowatt now, and Bash with the flame. Kilowatt seems to have pinned them down there. Matilda comes in from the rear. Kilowatt's lance doing the damage. That has proved so effective in Robot Wars. Matilda with the chainsaw. Kilowatt with the pincer and the lance. You can see the scratches and dents in there as well. The wheels spin. No traction, though. Not a bad run, but have they done enough? King Buxton.
Not far from the end zone.
No, I think we're not going to be able to polish those scratches out.
Oh, you did take a bit of a bashing from Matilda,
yeah,
didn't you?
Did.
You seem to have a bit of power as well. You couldn't push it back too much.
Oh, we got power. When we get it under control, it'll be interesting.
Okay, power to the king. King Buxton.
Will the king rule the roost? They think so. 10.6 metres is the benchmark.
I can't believe how sprinty you were in there. I mean, you sped down that side bit, didn't you?
Well, that's a little mice. Feed them lots of chews.
Yeah.
They run really fast.
Yeah.
So that's why they don't take the top off, they escape.
So will they need to have a seat now, those little mice?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah, they must be exhausted after that, but they were very brave.
Mm.
And so were you.
Thank
well
you
done.
Much.
Robot ears, stand by. 3, 2, 1, activate.
King Buxton the first to take on Matilda. Very nearly driving straight off the ramp. Matilda in underneath King Buxton. Look at the smoke there. There's been damage caused immediately to the motors. And off it goes. Well, you can see the scarring and the smudge of smoke there on the front. Major damage, 6.95 metres.
And the King Buxton team, I don't believe they actually made that robot because I've only ever seen them polished it in the pits.
The first semi-final, RoboDoc against King Buxton.
Robot ears, stand by. 3, 2, 1, activate.
King Buxton is the quicker, lighter, smaller robot, as you can see by a long chalk. Those titanium spikes look dangerous. This is good mobility, this is good style, this is good control, and it's pushed RoboDoc into the PPZ, the perimeter patrol zone, and dead metals, pincers, and the circular saw. Out they go. Done well to get out of there, and now RoboDoc itself comes in on the attack, trying to get the lifting arm and the spike underneath the flip. King Buxton almost turned up itself, but there's Kilowatt's camera. Also Shunt coming in with a pickaxe. Damage sustained by RoboDoc. Flipped up. You can turn it over, as we've said before, and it'll still come back. Look at the spike on the front and the lifting arm. Now King Buxton wheels and spins, trying to get back at RoboDoc. Avoiding each other. Oh, my goodness me. RoboDoc nearly went into the pit of oblivion, and Matilda's going to push him back there. Time is running out. RoboDoc heaves back at Matilda. Again, he's turned up onto its head. Over the flaming pit. Charcoal RoboDoc. It goes to the judges. They think they've done enough.
That's a spectacular fight. We have to rely on our panel of judges. And whilst they decide, let's see some highlights from that fight.
Right at the start, good mobility by King Buxton, getting away from RoboDoc, pushing it into the perimeter patrol zone. RoboDoc on the retreat. From Shunt and also King Buxton in underneath. There's damage sustained, you see. From Shunt's pickaxe. Almost flipped onto its side. Now that would have been a problem. Matilda veering it towards the pit. Just surviving. Who has won this great tussle?
Well, a decision has been reached by our panel of judges. It was such a spectacular fight. It's such a pity that one team's got to lose. But the judges have gone for King Buxton!
RoboCop, how's it, Steve? We love that fight. We loved it.
One more fight and you're through to the series semi-finals.
Excellent.
Can't wait.
You're feeling confident?
Feeling good now, aren't we?
Yeah, definitely.
Ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause. King Buxton!
And so to the final. King Buxton against All Talk.
Robot ears, stand by. 3, 2, 1, activate.
Two quick, powerful robots. All Talk is slightly the lighter but speedier. King Buxton seems to have more maneuverability with those spikes as well. Movable titanium spikes on King Buxton. Two large steel spikes in the front of All Talk. Being nudged ever backwards. Caught there on the edge of the pit of oblivion. One bash and two, they want to nudge him in there. In comes the Killalot as well. With that lance. Oh, they're just hanging on. No, they're not. All Talk was just that in the end. And King Buxton is the winner.
King Buxton, take the podium. King Buxton.
You must cook it out in the arena. All that hard work, all that effort, all that time, all that money. You're through to the series semi-finals, how do you feel?
It's not bad, is it?
It's not bad, is it? You don't sound very excited.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause!
From Hornchurch in Essex, King Buxton.
The movable titanium spikes are menacing, low, fast and highly manoeuvrable, but Captain Simon Harrison once built hi-fi speakers that were so big they couldn't be moved. No go for the go-go dancer. King Buxton, Captain Simon Harrison.
Unipits, the King Buxton team are really looking stressed.
Yeah, no, we're just staying calm. We're okay.
So you're not frightened of any of the robots at all?
No. I wouldn't say that. I would say he's not scared, he's the driver. He's a good driver.
No, we're confident. Just go out and see what happens.
3, 2, 1.
Steve Monk, Phil Brett and Simon Harrison have the power and pace here. Oh, look at that, through the brick wall. Oh, Shunt's drunk! He's got into the pit! Matilda's tusk is bent! Almost out of shape, what a run here by King Buxton! Speed, maneuverability, and they're through! Terrific!
King Buxton, come up to the podium! Yes!
Well, no problem there, eh?
No, it seemed to go quite well. The ball moved easier than we thought, and after that, I think we had a bit of luck.
Well, you put the ball in the end zone. A better shot than Robbie Fowler. You're in the end zone. Shunt's in the pit.
Or he should be.
Excellent, excellent.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, King Buxton, round of applause. Well done.
Give Shunt a breath test, someone. King Buxton completing the course.
King Buxton team.
Hello.
Why are you filing? I thought you said you had no work to do.
Well, it's something to do, isn't it? Just thought we'd have a bit of extra clearance and...
All right, well, you can do it now, then.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, activate.
We know King Buxton is fast. Those spikes can ram and lift. And through the bricks, there's a barrel turning away. Now, up and over the ramp. 15 points to get up and over that seesaw, carrying a brick all the way. King Buxton... something of an underdog, the title in Robot Wars. Avoiding the pit, certainly confounding the experts here. Going to get two robots go through from this second semi-final to our grand final. Killalot pushing King Buxton in onto the bricks. That could be a problem. Ground clearance only 50 millimeters, could get stuck. Well, not with speed like that. Spinning wheels, attempting 50 points, Matilda pushes away. I'm not too sure whether they've scored enough points, King Buxton. Very quick and nippy, but how many on the board? Only 165. The defending champion Roadblock, or the speedy King Buxton.
Robot ears, stand by. Three, two, one, activate.
Roadblock, top seeds for the competition when it began. In underneath, King Buxton. Worrying roadblock. Well, the judges will mark on aggression, don't forget. And also control. Oh, and that's not great control. Steering straight into the pincers of Dead Metal. Dead Metal's saw blade there, and also that of roadblock. The tungsten tipped teeth. Fighting and serrating. Chiseling. Little shove pushes roadblock back into the PPZ. Now that allows Shunt to the right and Dead Metal there at the bottom of the picture to come in. Roadblock champions. Look a little concerned. In up and under King Buxton. But piggyback style, he gets away. Now Killer Lock comes into the picture. So King Buxton thinks better of it and gets out of there. Pushing back on Roadblock. Whose siren blares is smoking. King Buxton is smoking and on fire. The engines have gone. King Buxton in all sorts of trouble. Roadblock comes in with a circular saw. Look at the damage done to the wheels there. Buckled and bent, bashed, beaten surely. On the spikes impaled, Dead Metal awaits too. They've got to get out of there now, King Buxton. Well, I think Roadblock's done enough here. The reigning champion surely through.
Roadblock are the trio winners. Come up to the podium.